What's up, y'all? It's your girl, Jay Renee, for Prison Riot Radio. I hope that you're doing well. On the line, we have two participants, Mr. Tony Mack and Mrs. Kanisha. We are going to get to talk to them for our installment for The Other Side of the Game. Brother Tony Mack has been incarcerated before. He has been home for 4 years. And now we are going to just chat with them about their love and their relationship. How y'all doing?
Great. All is well.
All right, that's good. How you doing, ma'am?
I'm doing awesome.
All right. So let's get right into it. So we know that, tell us a little bit about how y'all know each other. Y'all have known each other since childhood, correct?
Right.
Okay. So, I know that a lot of people have stigmas when it comes to the formerly incarcerated. So, y'all have known each other since childhood. Y'all have remained cool. And after the good brother was released, this is when y'all decided to see more into your relationship?
Yes, that's correct. You know, things got a little more serious, you know. Mm-hmm.
I can understand that.
And we both shared the same common interest of writing and creativity.
Okay. So I have a question for you, Kanisha. What made you feel okay with knowing the narratives that is out there besides knowing, you know, Tony personally? You know, it's a lot of stigma that comes with dating someone that was formerly incarcerated. So what was it in you that decided that despite all of these things that you was going to move forward with this relationship?
When I found out what Tony was in prison for, I didn't know those charges that he had. So when he got out, I started communicating with him a little bit more because he had already published Code Rush. Mm-hmm. So when I was... When I met up with Tony and we started talking about this publishing company, and I got very interested in the novels he had started writing, and so I had one too, so that's how we kind of like clicked.
Do you ever get any type of flack from your families and friends because of his former incarceration?
Definitely.
Yeah, I'm sure that's kind of hard. I know, like, I can relate a lot. So, you know, it's definitely a challenge. How do you stay motivated through those times?
I pray and I keep my distance, you know, and, you know, people don't say things regardless, you know, people talk. So, I don't let that bother me none whatsoever.
Right. Good job, sis. It can be hard sometimes, but we got to do what we got to do. So my next question is for you, Tony.
Absolutely.
You know, when did you know that Kanisha was the one for you?
I knew we shared a whole lot of things in common. We shared a lot of common interests, and she was different. She was something different that I wasn't used to. Mm-hmm. And she added a lot of quality in my life.
That's what a good woman do, bro.
Absolutely.
100%. So, you know, knowing that she sometimes goes through these hardships with people that don't understand your love, you know, how does that make you feel like you need to step up as a man at all? Or does it, like, how do you carry that in your space?
I mean, you know, I'm a pretty strong minded guy, you know what I mean? But at the same time, you know, I just prove them wrong by, you know, making sure that I continue to be a better man every day for my family and my community.
Right. So how long have y'all been together?
Almost 5.5 years, roughly.
Okay. So what's have y'all collaborated? I know you said that you both are into writing. Is there anything that you've collaborated on when it comes to writing?
Absolutely. We collaborated on the Baking Soda Game. That's by Kenesha Gillespie and myself, Tony McQueen. We are working on a three-book series, an anthology called The Money Hungry Mafia Chronicles.
Wow.
As well. And we just collaborated on a four-book children's book series under the imprint that we own, also called Truly Unique Publications.
And we also have another one that's coming out, hopefully in the fall. What's the name of that title? Subject of Envy.
Wow. That's so awesome. Well, congratulations on y'all books that's coming out. Where can people find y'all published works?
On Amazon.
Okay, Amazon.com. Everybody make sure that
you're
Walmart.
We also have, Walmart.
Okay, congratulations on making it into Walmart.
Yes, thank you. We also on Goodreads, we on Digital Book Girl, we on LinkedIn, Instagram, Twitter, all major social platforms.
Okay. So let me ask y'all this. How is it working together?
Great. Teamwork make a dream work. Right. I don't think I could have got this far alone.
I know that's right. Well, I'm definitely, I'm a lover of black love. I'm a promoter of black love, of love, period. So I always love when two good people get together and that, like you said, teamwork makes the dream work. And they're living their best life. So I extend love and congratulations to you guys.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
So I got two questions left, one for Tony and one for Kenesha. So I'm going to start with you, Kenesha. What advice would you give to a young lady that her significant other is formerly incarcerated and she's having a hard time with her family and friends accepting it?
She gotta be strong, and you live for yourself. You're not living for everybody else,
That's good advice. Definitely good advice. So let me ask you, Tony, what motivation or inspiration would you give to a young man that's on the free side of the G wall that might be having a hard time maneuvering and getting his footing?
Right. My advice is you got to stay grounded. You got to stay focused. And whatever it is you want to do, you have to learn all it is about what it is you want to do. You have to, first of all, you have to have a goal. Mm. And it's okay. A lot of us in the community didn't have mentors growing up. I have mentors. Mm-hmm. And, with a combination of having mentors and goals, you have dreams to pursue. You have something to go after. But if you're just drifting without no goals, without no plans, I mean, it's just like smoke and mirrors.
Right. Right. Great advice. I want to thank y'all for sharing this little bit of time with me, so we could talk about y'all love and y'all connection and let others know out there that it is definitely possible to, have the dream that people want and the love that people want. So I thank y'all very much for taking this time to sit with me.
Thank you so much for your time. I'm still going to shout Free Kwame T's to you. It's free. That's my brother.
Thanks.
And it was an honor of you.
It was an honor for this interview.
Thank you.
Oh, you're most welcome. Thank y'all.
All right.
It's your girl, J. Renee, with Other Side of the Game. Peace.